So I'm doing this video following a time after the George Floyd murders where tensions across the world and specifically in the US were one of its highest due to the protests, the rioting, the looting, in the speaking out of injustice across many platforms and specifically in the cyberspace, in online social media, tweeting and posting and things like that. And it got me thinking about the current state of cyberbullying and this aspect in some sense of misinformation. And so, you know, it's been an issue ongoing for the last 10, 20 plus years with the onset of internet and, you know, those things like that. But I was very curious, where are we in terms of stats when it comes to cyberbullying and expressing your opinion online and how it's being received and how people are actually giving that opinion online? And so I was very shocked by some of the stats that I've seen. According to the Pew Research Center, 95% of teens are connected to the internet, 85% are social media users across all ages, and that 87% of young people have seen cyberbullying occurring online. 36.5% of people feel they have been cyberbullied in their lifetime, and 17% have reported it has happened at some point in the last 30 days to them. And so basically this article is saying that cyberbullying hasn't decreased, but in fact it has increased over the last decade plus. And so that got me thinking how we should be approaching our relationships with both people that we do know as well as those that we don't know, how we should be conducting our conduct essentially. And so in this video, it's gonna be very simple. I'm just gonna go through some Bible verses, and a lot of us in this moment in time, it's June 2020, we're very heated and there's a lot of emotions across all sorts of people, and rightly so. There's a sense of injustice that you should have and that people should be stepping up to in the sense of acting out. But then at the same time, we have to be cautious, because I see a lot of people, even those that are Christian, claiming that they're doing certain things, but when they're posting and when they're saying certain things, it's coming out of their flesh and their feelings. And from as extreme as I've seen people, just dropping F-bombs, down to people, saying things that are justified by certain truths, but really there's a deeper motive behind it that allows them to kind of skew it. And so it's tainted with sin, essentially. And so I wanted to address some of these concerns through some Bible passages, as well as some thoughts that I had in this topic. And so the first thing I want to talk about is a few verses that outline how God sees and understands our heart, and something that we should be mindful of as we post and speak out, whether it's online or in person. And so Jeremiah 17:9 says, "The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it?" James chapter 4, verse 1 through 2 says, "What causes fights and quarrels among you? Don't they come from your desires that battle within you? You desire, but you do not have, so you kill. You covet, but you cannot get what you want. So you quarrel and fight, and you do not have because you do not ask God." James chapter 3, verse 6 through 9 says, "The tongue is also a fire, a world of evil among the parts of the body. It corrupts the whole body, sets the whole course of one's life on fire, and is itself set on fire by hell. All kinds of animals, birds, reptiles, and sea creatures are being tamed and have been tamed by mankind, but no human being can tame the tongue. It is a restless evil, full of deadly poison, and with the tongue we praise our Lord and Father, and with it we curse human beings who have been made in God's likeness." And so all those verses really allows me to be reminded of what my heart is feeling and what twistedness, according to Jeremiah, that you can have, and even deceiving yourself. And you could be lying to yourself when you say certain things, thinking that it's justified and there's a warrant to it, but really out of frustration, anger, it may be righteous anger, but in some sense it could also be anger that's not holy. And so if we're not careful, our hearts can really be deceiving us to move and act and feel in a certain way. But we've got to be able to step back and just kind of assess, what is it that my motive is doing for my heart, and how is that in response coming to my mouth and my tongue, as James is saying? How is that allowing me to say certain things, and without things bubbling up and me just being very not conscientious of what I'm saying and how I'm feeling, I could be shooting myself in the foot. And so that leads me to a couple of other verses. Romans chapter 14, verse 10 through 12 says, "You then, why do you judge your brother or sister? Or why do you treat them with contempt? For we will all stand before God's judgment seat. It is written, as surely as I live, says the Lord, every knee will bow before me, every tongue will acknowledge God. So then each of us will give an account of ourselves to God." And then Galatians 6 through 7 says, "Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever one sows, that he will also reap." And so basically, you know, God is watching. God is looking down and saying, you know, you've got to account for everything that you say, every single empty word, every single thing that you've ever, you know, whether it's online and in that small post where you think no one's like watching, or no, it doesn't even matter because I just posted this and, you know, a couple people saw it. The truth is, thousands of people can see that, and it's written there for the longest time. And what people read, it will, I don't want to say it'll define you, but it will definitely leave a mark, especially if it's with people that know you and doesn't give one an excuse to just say what they want. But, and so really what this is saying is that God is going to be looking at those things, and God is really going to be judging those words. And so it's, there's got to be some caution that needs to be exercised so that you can really, with the right mind and with the right heart, say the things that not only that you want to say and that's justified, but also that's not going to allow you, when you come before God, where you have to give an account to him, that he has to punish you. Or when you come before God, you have to, you know, answer to that, and he will accordingly judge those things. And so, but you know, that doesn't go against what you should be doing, whether as a Christian or just a social rights activist, in the sense of speaking out and acting so that you would do your part and standing up for injustice. Even Jesus in Matthew 21 verse 12 through 13 says, "Jesus entered the temple courts and drove out all who were buying and selling there. He overturned the tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves. It is written," he said to them, "my house will be called a house of prayer, but you are making it a den of robbers." And so in this instance, even Jesus, yes, he came out and he flipped tables and he spoke out against the injustice, and he was one to really take action for injustice. But he did it in a way where it was wise, where it was out of righteous anger. It wasn't out of a fleshly heart and consequently a regrettable decision. You know, a lot of these things that people are saying, you know, as I read it, you really sense that people are receiving this as being bullied. And so you could have even the right emoticons, you can have the right words, but if people are receiving it in a bullying manner, then it's the damage is done. That person has been cyberbullied. And so, and then of course this other verse, Matthew 7 verse 12 says, "So in everything do to others what you would have them do to you, for this sums up the law and the prophets." And that is what we call, as everybody knows, the golden rule. And you know, if you're treating other people the way that you want to be treated, and so does it make sense for, you know, a lot of us to be saying things in 144 characters, saying it, you know, out there, and then thinking there's no consequence? You know, people are going to be defensive, and people are going to be coming back with fighting words, an eye for an eye. And so it's very tough when a lot of things that are progressing, and I'm speaking at a time right now where, you know, we want to progress in this day and age with injustice and racism and things like that. But if people are fanning the flame of a fire, and this goes for many topics, just across the board in any part of the world and any time of life, where if you want to resolve something and if you want to get something settled, it's not going to help to be able to fan the flame by throwing things of words and of your feelings and your, this essentially the cyberbullying, to try to get your way and to try to solve things. And so I see it happen so often that people are not aware of it. And so one of the things that I just wanted to encourage people to do was to realize that the words that you say have a lot of meaning, and that it comes from a place, if you don't really evaluate your heart and evaluate your words and your tongue essentially, then it's gonna be consequential, because not only will it hurt those that are receiving it, because they claim that that's cyberbullying to them or that's oppression to them, but then you're going to have to account for that, you know, when you meet God. And so this is not in any way, you know, something that is to rebuke you. In some sense, it is rebuke, but it's just to encourage people to be mindful of the words that you say, because if we want to make progress, whether it's right now with the George Floyd movement or with, you know, any other circumstance in the future, you're going to want to be diplomatic, and you're going to want to have your emotions as much as possible in check, and you're going to have to be wise about what you say. Otherwise, it's going to have consequential effects even the rest of your life, and of course, you know, when we meet God. And so, you know, I'm making this video because I want to encourage a lot of progress. I want to encourage people to speak out, and obviously Jesus flipped tables, but in a way that would be wise and in a way that would allow progress, because it's evaluating the motives of your heart. And so, you know, I just wanted to give that as a word of encouragement. This, more than anything, was just a video where I just wanted to convey my thoughts and really encourage people to build up healthier relationships, both online as well as with the people around you, by ensuring that you're keeping your words in check. So thanks so much, guys, for checking out this video. If you liked it, please subscribe below. I'm gonna have a lot more content in the coming months as we slowly transition into coming back to in-person church. So thanks a lot.